Hello guys! Today I start series of videos about doing some useful stuff with Azure Portal. So the aim of this video is to show how to deploy a virtual machine with Ubuntu 18 in cloud service Microsoft Azure and after connect to this VM via Remote Desktop Protocol or RDP. Honestly, as a Windows user for all my life, it was a little bit hard, but anyway, now we will manage with it together. This video has subtitles in English and in Russian, so feel free to use them. So first, we go to Azure portal, portal.azure.com, and select a blade on the left called Virtual Machines. Yes, you should already have some subscription to create a VM. I already have a VM with Ubuntu on it. It's my own VM, but now we will create a new one. Click Add and let's put some specific information about our future machine. First, you need to select a subscription. I have an MSDN subscription and select existing or create new resource group. Resource group is some kind of folder where all your Azure resources can be stored. I will create a new one. VM test. Let's make a virtual machine name, for example, VM test UV. Select the region. I will choose Northern Europe. Next, select an image. Microsoft provides a lot of images with different operating systems. We will search for Ubuntu. I will select Ubuntu Server 18.04. Now, we need to think about the size of our machine. Let's see what they have. You can sort all the sizes by cost per month. I often choose B2S1. It's about $30 per month. It will be enough for our machine. Next, we need to create an account. I will use one with password. Put your username and the password. Don't forget to suit all of these rules. Confirm a password. And let's manage inbound port rules to give an access for a network. I will select Secure Shell and I will select Remote Desktop. Click Next. Microsoft provides premium SSD. It is included in the price, so we will take it. Networking is already managed. Management also. You can change all of these options after you deploy your virtual machine. And now, on the last page, Review plus Create, we have all of the information about our future machine. We have a price per hour. And now we just need to click Create. So our VM is anti-deploying. Now we need to wait about 10 minutes while it is making. We will download a PuTTY. So PuTTY is a free and open source terminal which supports several protocols, including Secure Shell. I will download this one. And start it. Now we will wait for deployment. Our deployment is completed. We can return to our virtual machine. Here is it. We have a lot of options there. Now we only need to know how to connect to it. And we will see two options for Secure Shell and for Remote Desktop. First, let's start with Secure Shell. We have a public IP address here. Copy it and put in PuTTY. The port is 22. You can save this session and open it. Press yes and log in to our VM. Terminal is ready. Now we will configure our Ubuntu. First, let's update some components. Type this command. Wait a little. Finished. Now we need to install an XFCE, a free and open source desktop environment for Unix operating systems. Just type this command. Yes, and we need to wait about 5 minutes. Next, we need to install an XRDP, special implementation of Microsoft RDP server that enables other systems and not only Windows have an experience of remote desktop. Type yes, wait a little. Finished. Now we need to make sure that XRDP uses an XFCE. Type and let's restart our service. Type done. Now we can connect to our VM. We have a dynamic IP, which we have already used, and also we have a DNS name. You can change it now. Put an easy name for you. Wait for the system to check it. No, I cannot use this one, only lowercases. Save it. Return to your virtual machine. So now you have access to it via IP address or a DNS name. First, let's connect by IP. Copy it. Open a remote desktop. Yes, it's in Russian, but it's remote desktop. Type your IP address and connect. Yes. Welcome to our VM. Again, repeat your username and password. Just waiting for connection. Default config. So welcome to our first start. So that's all. It was really, really easy. All the comments I typed are under the video. Don't forget that you can resize your VM or change its options. If you need some more inbound ports, just go to networking and add a new inbound port rule. Thank you all for watching. If it was helpful, don't forget to subscribe and put a like. See you, bye!